Welcome into the Wednesday episode of the David Hookstead Show. We're going to be doing something a little unique today. I'm actually filming this and then I'm jumping on a plane to fly to Wisconsin. So instead of you doing a usual rundown, we're going to be doing more of a five things I'm looking forward to. Five best things about the college football season. That's why I got my Badgers hat on. I got my Badgers sweater on. We got the helmets in the background. We got the football up there. So let's dive into the five things that I am most excited about this college football season. Number one, right away this season, we have a ton of great non-conference and the usual great conference games. We have right away in week one, we have Alabama-Miami, we have Clemson-Georgia, we have Wisconsin-Penn State, we have just a whole litany, a great lineup of games. And that first weekend, now we have week zero, August 28th, but that September 4th weekend, the first full slate, I think is quite frankly the greatest opening weekend of games that we've ever seen in the history of the sport, that we've ever seen in the history of college football. So I'm really, really, really excited to see what happens. So number one, why should you be excited about the return of college football? We don't have to wait at all for the great games to slide in. Week one is going to be the greatest weekend, opening weekend of college football I think we've ever had in history. And that alone is a reason to get amped up, reason to get excited. I mean, I'm super pumped for Wisconsin-Penn State. The Nittany Lions are coming all the way to Madison. Then you have Alabama playing Miami. You've got, like I said, Clemson-Georgia is that marquee nighttime game. So you got DJ Uiagalelei, I always butcher his last name, versus JT Daniels and the Bulldogs. You have Ole Miss-Louisville. You have UCF-Boise State. You just have such a great lineup. That whole weekend, I mean, if you're a girl, this is what I said, girlfriends out there, good luck finding your boyfriends when that first weekend rolls around. Something tells me that they're going to be incredibly difficult to get a hold of, but it's going to be a great time. Reason number two why we should all be excited for the college football season to start is simply it is a great outdoor drinking, grilling session, okay? Anytime from that September, really through about halfway of October, you're going to be outside with your boys. You're going to have a TV out there. You might have a few TVs in the living room. You're going to have the sound system going. It is going to be a great time to party. College football season, for me, pretty much I run the same routine every day. I get up super early. I crank out a bunch of work. I watch college game day. Have a couple beers to get things going. Then I find a location where I'm going to watch games all day. Well, that's the same thing I'm going to be doing this year. And I think most of you, the fact you're watching this tells me you're going to be doing the same thing. One of my buddies has a mansion. He's got a big projector screen in it, got a back deck. We ain't out there. We watch college football. We blast the noise, drink a bunch of cold beers. I got a 75-inch TV hanging in my living room wall from where I moved into. I haven't watched any college football on it yet, but I'm super excited to see what happens. So reason number two is it is a great excuse to get around your buddies, crack open a bunch of ice cold beer, watch it on big TV screens, grill a little bit outside, soak up some good weather. You know, it's just a perfect time of year to do things like that. And that's why you should be, reason number two, you should be really excited for college football. Reason number three, we really have no idea who's going to win it this year. I mean, this is a wide open year. You have Oklahoma, Clemson, Ohio State, Alabama, Georgia, you got Wisconsin, and in a really a group of about maybe three or four other teams that are going to be in the mix kind of all season long. Notre Dame will be up there for that. LSU will probably, well, depending on their quarterback situation, will be up there. So we really don't have any idea who's going to win the national title this year. So that's another reason to get excited. Usually you know it's going to be Clemson, Alabama, Ohio State. Well, Alabama's got a young quarterback. Ohio State's breaking in a new quarterback. No matter who they roll with, it'll be a new quarterback, right? Oklahoma, they have a great offense. They got Spencer Rattler, but can their defense, it's supposed to be much better, can it bring them a national championship? Wisconsin, our run game is what it's always going to be with Jalen Berger. Graham Mertz is a hell of a player. Our defense will be stout, but can we take that next step? This is the first year in a long, 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 long time where it feels like we actually don't know who's going to win the national title. And that in and of itself is a reason to get amped up and a reason to get excited. Reason number four, we're going to have packed stadiums again, assuming that these governments don't shut everything down and try to bankrupt our communities again. So reason number four to be amped is you're going to turn on the TV or you're going to be at the game and there's going to be tens of thousands of fans in the stands again, just like college football is always meant to be. Instead of no fans or partial fans or restrictions, we're going to have packed stands again. And I could not be more excited for that. And reason number five, college football is just simply a reminder of everything that makes America great. It's a reminder of why we love this country so much. It brings out the best in us. It brings out everything great about the USA. It gives us all a reason to cheer for the exact same thing. It gives us all a reason to come together for a few cold drinks, tailgate, debate, bring up our teams. So that reason number five is frankly probably the most important. It's a unifying thing. You know, this country for really the past eight, since COVID started, it's felt a little fractured, felt a little torn apart, and we need to stop that. We just need to come together, and college football is a great way to do that. So let's run down the list again. Number one, great time. We got a bunch of great teams, bunch of great games. Opening weekend is going to be fire from the get-go. Number two, perfect reason to party with your boys, perfect excuse to get together, crack open some beers, watch the game on the big screens, get away from the girlfriend or the wife for a little bit. Reason number three, wide open this season. We have no idea who's going to win. Could be Alabama, could be Oklahoma, maybe it's Wisconsin, maybe it's Ohio State. We have no idea who's going to take it all the way. Reason number four, we're returning to normal. We're going to have packed stadiums again. And reason number five, and the most important reason, college football is a blunt and important and beautiful reminder of what this country is all about. So for those five reasons and many, 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 many more that I can't include in here, that's why we should all be super excited for college football. I won't be filming a video this Thursday. I'm gone. I'm in an undisclosed location up north Wisconsin in the Minocqua region. If you see me, shout me out. Let's get a beer together. Otherwise, everyone, I'll see you all again on Monday. Have a hell of a weekend.